Am I the a-hole for telling my mom I am successful despite her, not thanks to her parenting? For context, I, 31 male, have a brother, Paul, 33 male, who is a screw-up. He's a felon, breaking into people's homes to steal valuables. And in general, Paul has no work ethic, no drive to improve, no moral compass. He's rude, cruel, and uneducated. I, on the other hand, have a PhD from my country's top university, and I started my own company, which is now employing 5 people full-time plus myself and my significant other. Our lives, our mother, Mary, 63 years old, favored Paul strongly. The greasy wheels get the grease principle. I could bring home perfect grades, and Paul all failing grades besides one barely passing grade, and mom would fall over herself congratulating Paul and buying him a new iPod. Well, my grades barely get me a nod of acknowledgement. I worked jobs after school ended summer, only for my salaries to be stolen by Paul to buy weed. And mom always gave him a pass. Our mother is a very warm woman, and I can tell that she wanted to celebrate even the tiniest achievement of Paul's to encourage him. And she didn't have the heart to punish slash discipline either me or my brother. But in the end, it screwed over both Paul and me. Paul was taught that mom will always bail him out, and that stealing is consequence-free, until the actual police was involved and not just our mom. I have been slowly unraveling with my therapist all the ways in which being essentially wallpaper my whole childhood led me to having attachment issues, intense anxiety, abysmally low self-worth, and an unhealthy habit to both bury myself in work and always feel like a failure no matter how much I accomplish. Then mom called me today to invite me to a big party to celebrate Paul getting a job. It's unskilled, in retail. By now, I fully expect Paul to be fired, or just decide to stop showing up less than 1 week in. I told mom no, because we live in different cities and it's not worth celebrating that mediocrity. It led to a heated conversation, and eventually her telling me that I need to give back because I'm prosperous. I shot back that I work to earn all I have, and with a mother like her, it was an uphill battle. She told me she always supported me, and I told her what I typed above, and hung up angry. She texted me, "I'm sorry you feel that way and that I'm still welcome to Paul's party." I've been pacing and restless. Was I an a-hole? Now for the top comments. Not an a-hole. It sounds like you reached your limit, and you're trying to set better boundaries for your own mental well-being. Definitely discuss with your therapist how you're feeling about what you said. Maybe they can give you a suggestion of how to address your mother in the future. I will. Therapy's Friday and it's gonna bother me until then, but I will absolutely address it with my therapist. If you haven't already, I suggest emailing your therapist what happened ahead of time, so they know what you want to address at a session, and or writing out what happened. It can help you relieve feelings and make sure you remember what you wanted to bring up. Hope the session goes well and helps you. Not stay home. "I'm sorry you feel that way" is a BS answer. You feel that way because of her neglect. And you're right. Celebrating him getting a retail job that you believe he'll lose in a short time is meaningless. If anything, further contact with either your mother or Paul will encourage them to start asking for things. She's going to expect you to allow your brother to bleed you dry just like she did. I think you're better off cutting both these people entirely loose. Not stay home. Your standards are higher and it would benefit you to stay away and visit mom and the family on a different day when they aren't celebrating Paul. It'll put you in a bad mood while that's going on. I've been quietly trying to avoid seeing mom when Paul is around, but it's hard because he still lives under her roof, and the distance means that each travel to see mom is a tall affair lasting days. I rarely see her these days, and the pandemic just worsened what was already happening. Next story is titled, "Am I the a-hole for telling my 24 male twin sister 24 female that she no longer has a brother?" So I had a fiancé 24 female and I just knew she was the woman I'd spend my life with. She was great in every way. Her and my sister clicked greatly and they became best friends, which was huge for me because my sister and I were best friends as well. So I'd go on double dates with her and her now husband. I found out my fiancé was cheating on me and blew up on her. She cried and said usual stuff, but I was destroyed and called off our engagement and broke up with her. She ended up getting in a relationship with her affair partner, which stands to this day. Afterwards, before I blocked my ex and everything as I simply forgot, I saw her post on Facebook a picture of her new boyfriend happily hanging out with my sister and her then fiancé. I got angry at my sister and told her I thought it was wrong for her to do that. I know that she's a grown woman, but I thought that she would be mad at her too, especially since we are so close. I mean, we are twins. She tried to explain to me that she loves me more than anyone, but that she cherishes her friendship with my ex and didn't want to let either of us go. I ignored her after that and she called me. We went back and forth, her trying to plead with me and me angrily refusing to see her point of view. I then told her, "Have fun with your new friendship. Don't contact me again. I'm done with you." And then blocked her and my ex and everything. Since then, I moved from our old apartment and have gotten a new one and changed my number. My father and a few trusted friends have this info and have been instructed not to give it to my sister. My father had been telling me that my sister had been distraught and wanting to talk to me, but I was pretty adamant that I didn't want to. He obliged. Then she called me on a new number and told me she was getting married and that she would love for me to be there. I was ecstatic at first, but then I remembered my ex had asked if she and her new boyfriend would be there, to which she replied that she was going to be a bridesmaid and that the boyfriend would be there. I then told her that as of now, we are both only children. A little harsh, but I was angry. I hung up the phone and blocked the number. They are married now, but my dad tells me that she is visibly distressed and that he is afraid it will take a toll on her marriage. I don't want this to happen, but I am in no way over any of this. I still feel betrayed twice. I don't really want to see her at all. My biggest thing is that when she was cheated on by her college boyfriend, who I became friends with, I scolded him and comforted her. But when I get heartbroken by my fiancé and soon-to-be wife, she feels like it's okay to mingle with her and the guy who helped break us up? It's as if I don't matter. Although I love her to death, I feel a lot of hatred towards her right now. So, am I the a-hole for telling her that we are only children from now on and completely shutting her out of my life? Look, while it's true that you do not control her and who she's friends with, you control yourself and your actions. You ask her to give up her friendship with someone who betrayed you. She refused. You decided that you didn't want her in your life anymore. The condition you've laid for her to be in your life is that she give up your ex. She doesn't want to. Clearly, she values that relationship than her relationship with you. Either that, or she's expecting you to come around to her way of thinking. As long as you stick to your guns and don't go around harassing your sister or ex, I think you're not the a-hole. She's allowed to make her choices, but then so are you. I feel like that's what it comes down to. Sister had to make a choice and doesn't want to live with the consequences. Also, don't be swayed by your father's report about your sister being visibly distressed and is worried that it will have a repercussions for her marriage. Anything that happens will be a direct result of her own decisions to value her friendship with your ex-fiancé over you. You certainly do not owe anything to her, much less your forgiveness in order to save her marriage or your relationship to each other. She made her own bed, and she can lie in it. Sister didn't want to let either of us go. And when she had to pick, she didn't pick you. But she wants to make amends? How would that work? She just wants to have her cake and eat it too. Not stay home. Also, your dad said that she's visibly distressed and that is afraid it will take its toll on her marriage. How so? Unless she cheats on her significant other like her BFF did to you. If I had to guess, the husband was an OP side about all this and the sister ignored him to get her way. Not an a-hole. The amount of people who truly think OP is an a-hole is astonishing. Dude's life gets nuked, and you all are like, get over it. She can gloss over his heartbreak, but when he does it, he's in the wrong? So much for empathy. So many fakers out here. Next story. Am I the a-hole for refusing to go on a vacation with my family due to my bratty nieces also being invited? The people invited on a vacation. My parents, 48 female / 52 male. My pregnant sister, 25 female, her husband, 29 male, and their daughter, 6 female / 4 female. Myself, 23 male. My sister, 21 female. My parents planned a family vacation for us from December 26 to January 1. They rented a cottage upstate with enough room for all of us. I don't want to go if my nieces will be there. I know I sound like a horrible uncle, but there's a reason for it. My sister / brother-in-law are earth parent types. My nieces were born at home with only sister, brother-in-law and a midwife, who doesn't have any medical background or credentials present. They literally let my nieces do whatever they want. For meals, my nieces are allowed to choose what they eat. So if they want ice cream or cookies, that's what they get. My sister / brother-in-law won't make them eat anything they don't want to. They aren't sending my nieces to school. I thought they meant homeschooling, but they are letting my nieces decide if and when they want to learn something. My sister calls it unschool. neither can count past 10. They don't always get the letters of the alphabet right and neither can write their own name. They're more interested in the tablet or watching stuff online. I don't even know how this is legal, but I looked it up and it's here. My nieces choose their own bedtime, so they can stay up all night. They sleep with my sister slash brother-in-law and can't sleep without their parents there, so all their sleep schedules are messed up. They can't stand to be away from sister to the point they follow her to the bathroom. My sister can't even go to the store without them or there's a tantrum. They are glued to her. My brother-in-law can get away with a few hours. One time we went skating, and it was just cold enough to be slightly uncomfortable. My niece didn't want to wear a coat, and my sister slash brother-in-law didn't make her. They said she would experience the natural consequences of her actions, but she was 3 at the time. They've never been to a doctor. One of them purposely broke a neighbor's window, and my sister slash brother-in-law don't do forced apologies, so niece didn't have to apologize to the neighbor. One of my nieces threw a tantrum because I wouldn't give her my coffee. My sister slash brother-in-law made more and gave it to her and said they can have whatever they want. That should have given her mine. It's hard enough for a few hours. I can't take a week in an isolated cottage with a single satellite TV, no internet, no cell phone reception. The cottage has a landline phone. In cold weather with only one vehicle for all of us. If my nieces weren't going, I would love something like this though. My work always closes between Christmas and New Year's, so I can't say I'm working. At Thanksgiving, I told my parents I have no plans before they ask. I declined without saying why, and upset was an understatement at my parents' reaction. They are pressuring me to go, because everyone else said yes. Does it make me the a-hole for declining? They're not happy. Now for the comments. Not only should you not go, you should tell them exactly why. Leaving that part out is the mistake. Tell them, stay home, have a nice vacation, the end. Not stay home. Let them experience the natural consequences of their actions. Yeah, they're setting their kids up for failure. Shaking my head. Not stay home. Dude, imagine not sending your kids to school. And then also not teaching them skills and raising them to be addicted to their phones at a young age. I feel so bad for these kids. Info, why were your parents so upset? Do they think that the girl's behavior is okay, or do they simply want every one of you to be miserable together? My parents don't seem to be bothered by my nieces at all. They're upset because they wanted this to be family time together. If my nieces weren't there, I would love something like this. I think they're hurt because I'm the only one who declined and my work is closed. And they know I don't have prior plans, so there's no reason in their minds. Not stay home. That sounds like a terrible situation to be stuck in. That also sounds like child mistreatment. Those kids deserve medical care and proper schooling. And they're being set up for failure when they enter adult society. I literally can't believe the people who do this to their children. In my opinion, it is extremely abusive. Denying children any stability at all is a truly terrible thing to do. These are not going to be healthy or capable adults in any way, even before the fact that they literally have no education or social skills. I seriously hope state governments step in and make this illegal and start cracking down and checking records. I'm not opposed to properly done homeschool, but it seems like most people now aren't doing it correctly at all. They just stick their kids in front of a screen for 2 hours a day and leave it at that. I don't understand how you can do that to a human. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for not carrying on a tradition my family started with my step-family? My mom died 8 years ago. She had me, 17 female, my sister's 14 female, 12 female, and my brother's 13 male, 11 male, with my dad. Dad is remarried. His wife has 2 kids of her own, 10 female and 9 female, and together they have 2, 3 male and 1 female. When I was born, mom bought me a necklace. Not a super fancy one, but something that could be customized and added to. And she added each of my siblings. And when they were born, they got them too, with all our names on them. We all have them. We all wear them. It's something special for us. A few months ago, my sister has noticed my baby brother's necklace and asked him about it. He explained it was a necklace our mom gave each of us and was a tradition we had as siblings. This brought up questions about why they and our half-siblings were never included. My dad asked me about it when he remarried, and I told him it was something I wanted to continue with the steps. He left it there. His wife did bring it up several more times. It ultimately was unhappy that I didn't want to keep it alive. Because I was always my mom's helper with them for my siblings, it was seen as changing the tradition if I didn't want to be part of it. My dad and his wife ended up getting a different thing to symbolize the blended family. But the question ultimately came back to the tradition started by my mom. My dad asked me the other day why I didn't want to continue the tradition with a step family. I told him it didn't feel right to me to continue my mom's tradition with people who are not my mom's family. He asked if that was the only reason. I admitted to him that I love my siblings more, and if I'm honest, I'm not sure love comes into the relationship I have with the steps or halves. That I don't feel very strong emotions for my step or half siblings, and I see even our future adult relationships differently. He told me he was glad I was honest. Yesterday, his wife cornered me and told me her girls are still upset we didn't keep the tradition. That they feel unaccepted, and like they're not true siblings and we're not a true family because I didn't want to do it for them. She then said my influence has my siblings feeling the five of us are more bonded to each other than with the steps and halves. She said not wanting to continue it shows that I'm okay with hurting people, and that it makes me a very cruel person. Am I the a-hole? You are not the a-hole. The necklace was a tradition with your mom, and your stepmom is never going to replace or take over the place in your heart where your lover your mom is. She has no right to try and manipulate you like this. Keep talking to your dad about how you are feeling as you navigate the situation. And I would tell stepmom that as an adult, her trying to bully five children who lost their mother and just want to keep her memory alive makes her a very cruel person. And a selfish a-hole. Not a-hole. The tradition your mother started was for her children. Your stepmother's children are in no way related to your mother. Ignore her. Your decision honors your mother and is not cruel. Not a-hole. Tell her that she's being hurtful and cruel to you. Do not let her guilt you. She's supposed to be the adult in the family, not the pouty kid who wants everything. Do speak with your dad and let him know what your stepmom is doing and how uncomfortable you feel about her.